Module-based planning provides complete planning and budgeting solutions for financials, workforce, capital, projects, and strategic modeling with built-in best practice predefined content, including forms, calculations, dashboards, drivers, and key performance indicators. Financials provides integrated driver-based planning for income statement, balance sheet, and cash flow. In planning, navigate to the Configure page. On the Configure page, you can enable strategic modeling, financials, workforce, capital, and projects. I'll configure financials. In Enable Features, select the predefined drivers, categories, and options you want to use. While you can enable more features later, Oracle recommends that you enable only the features that planners currently require. You can't disable features later. You can use your own accounts or select the provided accounts. I'll select the provided accounts. I can choose from a provided standard chart of accounts, or I can choose driver-based planning. For more information on using your own accounts, review Configuring Financials to bring in your own chart of accounts. For expense, I'm selecting Marketing, Travel and Entertainment, and Facilities. I'll enable income statement reporting with gross profit and simple planning options. My balance sheet is driver-based. My cash flow method is indirect. I'll select account categories to add account groups to support cash flow reporting. You can enable rolling forecast for revenue, expense, balance sheet, and cash flow to allow continuous forecasting beyond a one-year time frame. You can enable weekly planning so planners can plan and forecast on a weekly level. You can map existing dimensions to financials dimensions, rename base dimensions, and add custom dimensions in this section. When you add custom dimensions, you also specify to which features the dimension applies. Both product and services apply to revenue. You must perform this step the first time you enable financials. Always review your selections before proceeding. Enabling features takes a moment to complete. When a confirmation message is displayed that financials was enabled successfully, log off and log back on to see your changes. Notice the financials card on the home page. Let's return to the configure page. Here are the features I enabled. If you need to enable additional predefined features, go to the Enable Features page. Let's continue configuring required drivers, metadata, and data. I'll set the time frame and granularity for plans by defining the scenario, period, and year valid combinations. I'll set the current fiscal year, period, and start year. You can set the period granularity for both plan and forecast scenarios. Review your selections and save your changes. Next, enter or load metadata and data for required dimensions, such as entities. I'll be importing from a local CSV file. You can select the file delimiter used in your file and select to delete existing members. After reviewing your selections, click Import. You have the option to refresh the database right after the import process completes. Since I have additional configuration tasks to complete, I'll hold off running the refresh database process until I've completed them all. Now, I'll work with my expense accounts. You can work with specific areas of the account hierarchy by selecting options from the category and component drop-down lists. Using the Actions menu, you can add categories, new members, predefined members, or import and export members. I'll take a look at the available predefined members to see if there are accounts that I can use in my application. These members were already added to the expense category. I'll add a new member instead. I'll create a new marketing expense account for social media campaigns. This will allow our planner to separate traditional marketing campaign expenses from social media campaign-based expenses. For the rest of the configuration, make sure to complete all required areas, as well as sections needed by your organization's planning type. After performing configuration tasks, you must refresh the database to see the changes in your application. Use the Actions menu to review modified artifacts. You can filter artifacts displayed on this page. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.